paths meet in the shadow.
Madame Patua thanks you for returning our Clarissa to us.
She is the gentle heart.
A stranger walks into a town with a lost lover in tow. Sounds like the beginning of a jest, which I bloody wish it were. Problem is, we're still one doe-eyed lover short, which ain't much good to anyone. They tend to come in pairs, you see. Since you seem to be in the good deeds business, how about throwing a tollman into the bargain?
Keep your distance, Exile. The name's Grigor, and when you've had your eyes fill of my twisted visage, how about you turn those fine jellies of yours eastward? Yes, you've brought Clarissa home to us, and once again...
Huntress, you are beatific because you answer to no one. And that's why no one will miss you.
That would only slow me down. That would only slow me down.
Tolman's dead then. Another victim of Piety's cruelty. Perhaps he escaped lightly. Look upon Grigor to see what life entails under Piety's influence. Let me offer you something, in recognition of all that you have done for us. We shall mourn Tolman's death as we shall treasure Clarissa's life. General Gravisius demands absolute obedience from his blackguards, meaning he's surrounded himself with cowards and lackwits, unable to lift a finger without orders. If you're able, traverse the river and murder Gravisius in his own barracks. He'll be ripping the very mind from the skulls of our enemies. Dominus and his Ebony Legion arrive.
I need to give you something. What is it?
I walked halfway across this.
Victoria was a poet. Come over here. You get him, boy.
Blackguards will never stop pursuing. Greetings.
That would only slow me down.
Beatles poet.
That would only slow me down.
Thank you.
That would only slow me down. That would only slow me down. You've given me so much. What can I do for you, Rayclast?
Yeah.
I've never felt further from what I know and love.
Full pocket, savage, spills forth like a struck spring.
There you go. What's going on?
are not a cockroach. Stray. The ribbons are order.
Spring.
That would only slow me down. Would only slow me down.
They're my ribbons forevermore. Forevermore. I hate forever. I could tear happy ever after from Bard's bleeding tongues. You're still here, not a cockroach. Oh, gratitude. Yes, I should give you a token. A token. What token? This? Cockroaches will come again. I like you.
That would only slow me down.
I awoke, feverish and barely conscious. I set to drawing these maps through the sable hours. By morning, my fingers ached, my eyes burned, yet still I found no rest. The reverie commanded its rendering. The reverie device now stands completed. I've placed the first of my maps within its receptacle. I've taken my maiden voyage into nightmare. I know now that which sent me this precious gift. It knows me, expects my return. It would be foolish to disappoint. Malachi.
Thank you. is a familiar face. Before you say anything, yes, I did try to kill you. Inexcusable. I allowed pragmatism to overcome honor in a moment of desperation. Please accept my deepest apologies. And what do you say? Can the two of us make a fresh start? Marvelous! Interested, are we? Oh, splendid! In return, I have a gift or two that I may bestow upon you with a click of my translucent fingers. All you need do is furnish me with a crystal decanter and a juicy piece of fruit. Two humble items that remain agonizingly out of reach for a man in my peculiar situation. Will you look at that? The decanter spiritus. As exquisite today as when I found it all those years ago. You may fault the man, but you can't fault his craftsmanship.
Would only slow me down.
The Gemling Queen? She's impossible. How did she survive? Why is she not one of the undying? No, these questions can wait. There's a more pressing one. Is she safe from the Ebony Legion? You've been busy. With the spool back where it belongs, the ribbons should be able to keep the Ebony Legion at bay. We've both seen what they can do to a man. Whether you were saving your own skin or thinking of others, it matters little to me. You succeeded where I did not. You have stood in the presence of the Gemling Queen. I can only hope to meet her in my nightmares.
You have thormetic sulfite? You are a resourceful unbug now, aren't you? Give it to me. I was all eyes and ears when Malachi worked. I know exactly what to do. A dash of arcanity, a pinch of insanity, a whisper of profanity, and the infernal It's the most explosive of powders. A sprinkle, the gentlest of dustings of infernal talc, will provoke gems to a molten rage. For the undying, the very sun will rise within their flesh. They will burn for their sins, not a cockroach. They will burn.
Look at the sheen on that plum. Is it not the most delectable fruit that you've ever seen? No? Perhaps the glass of hope is for my eyes only. Wondrous! Nothing bonds two souls more soundly than murder. For that reason alone, I knew you could be relied upon. Now, for a little amateur vintnering, a quick squeeze of the plum lights. A toast to swift endings and promising new beginnings. Oh, and you might want to avert your gaze once I have quaffed this diabolical brew. I doubt that my return to solidarity will be a pretty one. Right. Oh, my. Thank you.
God gave this world to man, not to you, little girl. For God, who do you fight for, Exile?
Without men like you, Gravisius, this land might just start healing itself.
You are the true spirit of the Makoru, the shark. Not the cowardly beast that sinks its teeth into the lonely swimmer. You strike the Waikoama, the canoe, spilling a feast of men into the water. Hunters turned hunted, that you dine on at your pleasure. Have this, Makoru.
Despite every...
You've so much to answer for.
pursued a greater existence for us all. What have you ever done but serve yourself?
Death doesn't fix anything, Piety, but at least it won't get any worse.
Wherever he...
Piety dies. Unfortunately, Piety was...
You have claimed the most worthy of Prime.
Piety's off to meet the Maker.
Can I help you?
Why do we insist on building mountains? Why not just go and climb them?
purpose to tempt and try the will of men.
Thank you.
Some of us live to regret our mistakes. Some of us don't. Try not to take it personally.
You have mounted the summit of the Empire, not a cockroach. You have crushed the Bug Emperor and wiped his maggot dreams from the skin of Rayclast. Dominus exiled you, naked and alone, unto the palm of death. But you would not die, would you? No. No! You cuddled death, promised it the world, made it your loving pet, and so generously shared it with all your fleeting friends here in Rayclast. Not once did you forget what you were. Not a cockroach feeding on the corpse of a dead empire, like the pests you crushed as you walked. A woman. The sort of woman that planted the seed of this empire right here in Sound so long ago. What teetering and twisted life it still holds dear. This land owes to you, Ranger. Of course, there will be more. You know that, don't you? Emperors. Avaricious little pests scrabbling to steal the legacy of their betters. Unless we burn that legacy, sear its infection from the flesh of existence. Go north, my lovely unbug. Go to Highgate, to the beginning of the end. Dive headlong into the nightmare sea. Catch and roast yourself a nice big fishy.
Cities are a blight upon nature, and Sarn was the foulest of them all.